Hello everyone, welcome to the session on 3 address code generation for Boolean expressions. In this video, we'll be seeing that how the translation scheme is provided for the Boolean expression, how the 3 address codes are generated for the Boolean expression in the compiler. Talking about the learning outcomes of this session, at the end of this session, students will be able to generate this translation scheme for Boolean expressions. And you can convert a given Boolean expression into its 3 address code using the translation scheme. Now, about the Boolean expressions can be used by many ways. So, two ways are like we can use them for computing the logical values like true and false values, and another one we can use them in the conditional expressions. Either we can use them for if then else statements or we can use them for loops also. Now consider this grammar. What this grammar is? This is the grammar provided for Boolean expressions. The expression is containing the operators or and not. You may have the expression in bracket, or the expression may be in the form of id, the relational operator, and id. The relational operators may be denoted by less than equal to, greater than equal to, or not equal to in any form. And it may have the values of true and false. So, this is a normal grammar for the relational operator for the Boolean expressions. Here, or and are having left associative. And talking about the precedence of the relation, we know that not is having the highest precedence in the relation, and then and operator, and then or operator. Now, taken into considering all these one, we'll be seeing the next thing, that how the Boolean expressions are converted in the 3 address code. Now, let us talk about the methods of translating the Boolean expressions here. Now, Boolean expressions, when we are translating them, usually they are in the two forms. The first method is by considering the numerical representation. What is numerical representation? In this one, we are encoding the true and false values in the numerical way, like 1 as true and 0 as false value. And we are evaluating the Boolean expressions like the arithmetic expressions. The second method is using the flow of control. In this one, we are representing Boolean expression by the position. Like if we are using them, these are usually convenient for if then else statements and loop statements. Here we are using Boolean expressions for moving the control of the statement. Like if the normal flow of the control is there, and if you want to change them using the expressions, we are using that. Now consider this numerical representation here. What is it there? The example is A or B and not C. So this is the relational expression, and see the 3 address code generated for this one. How it is generated? Now see here that according to the precedence of the operation, not is having the highest precedence, then and is the next precedence, and then or. So this expression is executed as first not C is calculated, then and is calculated, and then finally or. So this is the result of this one. So this is the 3 address code which it is generated for this particular example. Take another example here. The simple expression is a less than b. This is taken as if a less than b, then take it as true, else take it as a value 0, that is a false value in the numerical representation. So this one, when we are converting in a 3 address code for changing the flow of the control, you can see here that this 3 address code is, we are considering the statement which is starting with 100. Now, if A is less than B, then go to 103. That is what, if it is true, A less than B is true, then it is going to take the value of T as 1. Else, it is taking the value of T as 0. So, once it is taking the value of T as 0, it will go to 104. That is, it is coming out of this one. So, this particular expression is converted in 3 address code here like this. Now, this is the translation scheme for Boolean expressions in the numerical representation form. This is the grammar what we have seen earlier, the same grammar is there. And these are the semantic actions for that. Means if this is the matching statement, then how the semantic action, what action it is taking. Now in this one, basically two functions we are using here. One is the emit function, What is the emit function? Emit function is used for generating the three address code, and new temp, that is the function which is generating every time we require the new temporary variable like t1, t2, what earlier we have seen. So for these one, we require to generate the temporary variables. So for that, now you can see here that if the statement is e1 or e2, then first we require a temporary variable here. So the attribute e.place is generating a temporary variable, and e.place value is nothing but a temporary variable whatever it has created. Then emit function is used. What this emit function is doing? It is generating the three address code and it is keeping its it is there. So in this e.place value, whatever the place value is there, that equal to anything in a single quote is taken as it is for the three address code here. So this assignment statement is taken as it is, then even.place or is taken as an operator, and then e2's place. Similarly for and also, that is a temporary variable is created, then even.place assigns to as it is, and the and operator is taken. For not also, and for bracket, it is only exchanging the place value. Relational operator, in this we require a temporary variable, then we require if, now this it is generating the code, if that particular id, then the relational operator, then id's place, then go to. Now how the it is emitting the spaces now, that is go to, we have seen earlier 103, 104, according to that it is calculating. We'll see this by the example later. And the normal true and false value, if the normal true and false value are there, how the code is generating is place value. If it is for true, then it is 1, and for false it is 0 for the temporary variables. Now as I told earlier, that emit function is used for generating the three address code here, new temp function is used for generating the temporary variable, and the relational operator, it is containing next state and it is giving the index of the next three address statements in the given output sequence. Let us see how it is there. Take an example, earlier same example, if a less than b, then 1L0. Now this we have seen that the three address code is generated for this. Now according to this translation scheme, how this code is generated, let us see that one by one. So the first statement is what? E.place new temp. So here what it is doing, we are considering the next state as 100. So 100 is taken as it is, then place value is a new temporary variable here. So it has generated. Next is what? The emit statement. So in this emit statement, now see here what it is emitting. If as it is, then id1.place, so that is a, relational operator is less than, id2.place, that is b. Now go to as it is using. And next state is what? It is 100, and we are taking 100 plus 3, so that is 103 it is writing here. So like this statement is generated by this emit statement. Next, the next statement is generated by this emit e.place assigns to 0. So what is e.place? We have taken e.place earlier as temporary variable t, so t assigns to 0. The next statement is generated by this emit statement. So go to as it is writing, currently what is the current statement, next state value, that is 10 true. Now 102 plus 2, that is 104, so it is writing go to 104 here. Then this statement is created. Now in this one what is there, it is emitting e.place, it is for true value, so e.place we have taken as t, and t is assigning the value as 1. So like this one, it is generating the three address code by this one. We have seen that how this is generated by this one by one. So totally, first the temporary variable is created, then this statement is emitted by this, then this statement is emitted by this, this statement is generated by this emit statement, this statement is generated by this given statement. Like this, a complete three address code is generated. Now pause the video and try to convert the given Boolean expression into three address code using the above translation scheme. The relational operator, the expression what we are using here is p greater than q and r less than s, or u greater than v. Now see here, we have to consider the precedence of relations also, how the precedence of operations are working. So here and is calculating first and then or is calculating. So according to that, let us see the answer for that, how the three address code is generated by this. Now in this one, how the three address code is generated, you can see that first it is generating the three address code for p greater than q. So this is the three address code for p greater than q. Now this is for r less than s by the AND operator, and then this is for u greater than v, and based on that these are taken. So first p greater than q is calculated here, then r less than s is calculated here, the next one, and u greater than v is calculated, and finally first AND operation is taken place, so that is t1 and t2 and t4 or t3. So this is by these one. So like this the three address code is generated by this one. Take a look of this. These are my references. Thank you.